Well, I suppose you know then that Hollywood is planning a feature film about Radioactive Man. I have got to do something about that air conditioner suction.
Students, I have an announcement. One of your favorite comic book heroes, Radio Man.
Radioactive Man, stupid!
Strange. I shouldn't have been able to hear that. Anyway, a Hollywood studio has decided to film the Radioactive Man movie here in Springfield.
Yay!
And they will be holding auditions to find a local youngster to play Fallout Boy. Oh, and the air conditioner will be fixed this afternoon.
Next!
At last the world is safe, eh, Fallout Boy?
Watch out, Radioactive Man!
Brilliant reading again.
Watch out, Radioactive Man!
Fantastic! One more time!
Watch out, Radioactive Man!
Congratulations, Bart Simpson! You're our new Fallout Boy! That's what I'd be saying to you if you weren't an inch too short. Next!
Up and at 'em.
Up and at them.
Up and at 'em.
Up and at them.
Up and at them.
Up and at them.
Better.
Milhouse! Hey, you're not Milhouse.
No, I'm just Milhouse when he gets hurt. Oh.
Okay, let's get the real Milhouse over here under the X-ray truck.
Oh.
Hi, Bart.
Hey, cool, Milhouse. You get to be crushed by a truck.
It sounds like more fun than it really is.
Hey, I think I'm lying on a broken bottle.
Beautiful. Use it. Okay. Fallout Boy origin scene, take one. Action.
Up and at them.
That was perfect. Let's do it again.
These aren't real X-rays, are they?
Good question. We'll check into that. Okay, X-ray machine to full power and action.
You guys work in a movie?
You're saying we're not working.
Oh, I always wanted to be a teamster. So lazy and surly. Mind if I relax next to you?
This is the hardest, most expensive scene in the movie, and we only get one shot at it, so we have to do it right. Fallout Boy will untie Radioactive Man and pull him to safety moments before he's hit with a 40-foot wall of sulfuric acid that will horribly burn everything in its path. Now, that's real acid, so I want to see goggles, people.
Real acid?
Okay, roll film. Tip the acid bats and action.
Only Fallout Boy can save me now.
Where's Fallout Boy? Fallout Boy?
Uh-oh.
My eyes, the goggles do nothing.
Where in the hell is Milhouse? That one shot cost us $1 million.
Where's the producer? I want to talk about this coffee.
I withhold the truth. May I go straight to hell, where I will eat naught but burning hot coals and drink naught but burning hot cola.
Where fiery demons will punch me in the back.
Where my soul will be chopped into confetti and strewn upon a parade of murderers and single mothers.
Where my tongue will be torn out by ravenous birds.
Ah! Bart did it! That part right there!
Milhouse!
Milhouse, you did the right thing. Bart, come with me for punishment. You too, Snitchy. I want you to clean every one of these organ pipes to be fouled with your popular music.
You, Shank, how could you tell on me?
Well, I don't want hungry birds pecking my soul forever.
Soul? Come on, Milhouse, there is no such thing as a soul. It's just something they made up to scare kids, like the Boogeyman or Michael Jackson.
But every religion says there's a soul, Bart. Why would they lie? What would they have to gain?
I don't hear scrubbing.
Oh, yes, yes, that'll be
perfect. Get out of the mouth.
Slow down.
Yeah, get out of there. Hubbard Beach Cock stole every idea I ever had. He came into my room. And they
Who's
took
been stealing your thoughts?
And they put everything. Did you ever read the old curiosity shop? They made that with a John Gilgo.
La 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 la. So long.
Cartoons don't have messages, Lisa. They're just a bunch of hilarious stuff, you know, like people getting hurt and stuff like that.
Look, kids. I just got my party invitations back from the printers.
Come to Homer's BBBQ. The extra B is for BYOBB.
What's that extra B for?
That's a typo.
Dad, can't you have some other kind of party, one where you don't serve meat?
But all normal people love meat. If I went to a barbecue and there was no meat, I would say, "Yo, Goober, where's the meat?" I'm trying to impress people here, Lisa. You don't win friends with salad.
You don't win friends with salad. You don't win friends with salad.
You don't win friends with salad. You don't win friends with salad. You don't win friends with salad. You don't win friends with salad.
You don't win friends with salad. You don't win friends with salad. You don't win friends with salad.
Mom! I didn't mean to take sides. I just got caught up in the rhythm.
What is that anyway? It's tomato soup served ice cold.
Go back to Russia!
Milhouse has Bone Storm! This is great! And all I've done is enter my name! Thrill House!
Sorry, it's league night. I couldn't give a lane to my own mother.
I have no son.
Man, you go through life, you try to be nice to people, you struggle to resist the urge to punch them in the face, and for what? For some pimply little puke to treat you like dirt unless you're on a team. Well, I'm better than dirt. Well, most kinds of dirt. I mean, not that fancy store-bought dirt. That stuff's loaded with nutrients. I can't compete with that stuff.
In fact, I am going to give this school a perfect 10. I'll just write the 0 first. Now a vertical line to indicate the 1. Dinner? Why are there children walking on my head?
So, we meet again, Mad Magazine.
How do you know it's for Mad?
The year was 1968. We were on recon in a steaming Mekong Delta. An overheated private removed his flak jacket, revealing a t-shirt with an iron-on sporting the MAD slogan, up with miniskirts. Well, we all had a good laugh, even though I didn't quite understand it. But our momentary lapse of concentration allowed Charlie to get the drop on us. I spent the next 3 years in a POW camp, forced to subsist on a thin stew made of fish, vegetables, prawns, coconut milk, and 4 kinds of rice. I came close to madness trying to find it here in the States, but they just can't get the spices right.
My punishment?
Hmm? Oh, I'm going to have to think about that. Meanwhile, wear this home.
Hey!
Hallelujah!
Live from the famous brown sands of Public Beach, Delaware, it's the Grand Nationals of Sandcastle Building. Preview.
Oh, Saturday afternoon TV is so boring.
Bikini Girls. Dune Buggies. Daredevil Surfers.
Ordinarily, this beach would be swarming with them, but not today. Oh, no. They've all been cleared out to make way for painstaking sand preparation.
That's right, Dick. You know, this year, everyone's abuzz about one thing, the absence of Mark Rodkin. Oh, wait, there he is.
Well, sir, looks like we got some nice items here at Table Glick. Like this. What the heck-a-rooney is this, Mrs. Glick?
It is a candy dish, Ned. $90.
Uh-huh. Well, I guess you could put a lot of nice things in there.
No, just candy, Ned. $90.
Hey, big spender! Dig this blender! Rainbow suspenders! Hey, big spender!
We surrender!
Table 3. Thank you, neighbors. Thank you. Now let's give it up for Table 5. Table 5.
See what's on the other broadcast. Where's the oscillator on this thing?
No, Grandpa, no!
Darn it! What is this doing? Oh, I'll make my adjustments here and...
Yay!
We're getting a new TV!
Rusty was supposed to sign this. Take it back and make him sign it.
No, stamping the back of a check is perfectly legal, little boy. Many people do it to save time. You see, in this case, instead of writing out his name, Krusty has stamped the name of his Cayman Islands Holding Corporation on the... excuse me a minute.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't divulge information about that customer's secret illegal account. Oh, crap. I shouldn't have said it was a customer. Oh, crap. I shouldn't have said it was a secret. Oh, crap. I certainly shouldn't have said it was illegal. Ah, it's too hot today.
Bought this popcorn fair and square.
Sorry, the bank is... Oh, kid, gosh, I meant to tell you. Turns out that Krusty is one of the biggest tax cheats in history, and they nailed him, all thanks to you. Some might say you're a hero, kid. Not me, however. I love Krusty.
I've got some customers. Call me back, Ishmael. Ahoy there, minnows.
Ahoy, have you seen this man?
Nah, that's Handsome Pete. He dances for nickels. Pete, you got some customers.
No, we're looking for this man, Krusty the Clown.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to an evening of exciting quarter-mile action, action, action. Our first race is a benefit for Daredevil Lance Murdoch, who's hospitalized with cirrhosis of the liver. Liver.
Yay!
Liver!
One of these must be a breakfast maker.
Well... it's my job to cook him breakfast, and I'm gonna cook the best damn breakfast he ever ate.
Donuts? I told you I don't like ethnic food. Here, tell me how my stocks did yesterday.
They all won.
Hmm? What about my options?
Well, you can either get up or go back to sleep.
I believe I'll get up.
Some days, we don't let the line move at all. We call those weekdays. Good one.
Oh, well, at least I'm not stuck at the cracker factory like Milhouse. Wow!
Ever wonder how crackers get salted?
Have I? Wow!
Crackers, ho!
I never knew cracker production could be so exciting. But where do they make those crackers with that peanut butter already inside?
Put this on and come with me, son.
I've been driving all night, my hands wet on the wheel. There's a voice in my head that drives my heel. It's my baby calling, says I need you here.
Bart, Nelson hit me.
He sure did.
A cup holder! Bart, we gotta stop and get a cup! Bart?
Cruise control, my good man. Everybody all set back here? Nelson, good to see ya. Martin, always a pleasure.
What? Oh! We've arrived in the vast cornfields of Canada! How much farther to the Grammar Rodeo?
Grammar Rodeo? We're going to a Grammar Rodeo?
We're not going to a Grammar Rodeo. That was just an alibi, Milton.
Martin.
Fellows?
What?
Where are we going? Well, I realize it's trite, but we could tour the bridges of Madison County.
Hey, who has better vacation ideas than AAA? According to the publisher of this AAA guidebook, no one.
I've always wanted to see Macon, Georgia.
Wait, how about a fair? Not just a county fair, not just a Europe fair, but a World's Fair. The World's Fair in Knoxville, Tennessee. Keep reading. The Hungarians have built a giant motorized Rubik's Cube, and the fair's symbol is the Sun Sphere, which sits atop a 266-foot-tall steel shaft.
What's inside?
An information desk.
Cool.
So, it's a choice between Disney World and Knoxville.
Knoxville! Knoxville! Knoxville!
I concur.
What is this place?
Branson, Missouri. My dad says it's like Vegas, if it were run by Ned Flanders.
Andy Williams!
We don't need to stop here.
Yes, we do!
My huckleberry friend, Moon River, and me.
Now, tell Dr. Nick where is the trouble.
I'm edgy. I got ants in my pants. I'm discombobulated. Give me a calmative.
Slow down, sir. You're going to give yourself skin failure. Okay. Now, the symptoms you describe point to bonus eruptus. It's a terrible disorder where the skeleton tries to leap out the mouth and escape the body.
No, you're talking.
Our one chance is transdental electromicide. I'll need a golf cart motor with a 1,000-volt capacimeter. Stat!
Doctor, I can't in good conscience...
Now there's no time, man! We'll have to improvise. Keep doing that every 5 seconds.
Dr. Nick, we owe you an apology. Consider the charges dropped.
All right! Free nose jobs for everybody! Yeah, you first.
Give me a Van Heflin.
Here's your last question. What was the cause of the Civil War?
Actually, there were numerous causes. Aside from the obvious schism between abolitionists and anti-abolitionists, economic factors, both domestic and international, played a significant...
Hey. Yeah. Just say slavery.
Slavery it is, sir.
Yes, I am a citizen. Now, which way to the welfare office?
What?
I'm kidding. I work.